Ah, ito kailangan mo. 2080 Ti. Internet, nakakuha ka ng good deals ng Black Friday at may bagong rig ka na, congrats! Or you might be like me, na sad boy, na walang nabili. But either way, you need software to run your new hardware. Ito yung mga software na auto-install sa akin. Kahit anong specs, kahit anong build, ini-install ko mga programs na to. First of all, Windows. Yes, kakalabas lang ng Windows 11, but on launch, may bug siya that reduced performance on Ryzen CPUs by as much as 15%. Na-patch nga yun, but who knows what other bugs are out there. So currently, we still recommend using Windows 10 Pro 64-bit. Very easy to install, get the installer from Microsoft, and then to activate, go to cdkeyoffers.com. Who also, akalain mo, sponsored this video? Make an account on their site, click the link in the video description, type in our discount code HS20 to get a 30% discount. So nagiging $13 na lang yung activation code. Plug that code in, pay, and then you get an activation key that looks something like this. Go to your Windows, search for Activate Windows, plug in the CD key, and you're good to go. As I've mentioned in many of my videos, I do use CD key for my own personal use as well as for the needs of the shop. Kung may Windows ka, kailangan mo rin ng MS Office because you can't adult without Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. CD key has an activation code for that too. Check out the link in the video description, use our discount code HS20 again, tas nagiging $45 na lang yung MS Office. So you have Windows, you have MS Office, let's start getting to the fun stuff. Yung unang-unang program na ginagamit ko is Ninite, which is basically a bundler for the other programs. Di mo na kailangan dumaan sa iba't ibang installers, lahat naka-bundle na sa Ninite. You just choose the programs that you want to install. So these are my choices on Ninite. Unang-una, ShareX. This is to take screenshots of your desktop. Tapos, ba't mo kailangan yun? For example, you sent money via bank transfer, you're paying for something, tas kailangan mo i-viber dun sa seller yung payment confirmation, madali na lang to screenshot. Or napadaan ka sa website ni Hardware Sugar, nakita mo yung mga GPU prices, at naisip mo, grabe tong shop na to, palaging overpriced, tinayupak kayo. Sa galit mo, popost mo sa internet, tinan mo to, ang taas ng prices. You can do that super easy, even though we're not overpriced. It's super easy to take a screenshot of anything using ShareX. You can add emojis, text, you can blur out stuff. Kumbaga, ready na yung screenshot mo once you take it. You don't need to take a screenshot and then dun ka lang magpo-photo edit. You can also choose a bunch of browsers on Ninite. Personally, I use Firefox and Chrome. Firefox because I find it faster, and Chrome just because there are added Google integrations. For my workflow, I like using certain sites in certain websites. Yung Gmail ko actually Firefox, pero yung pwede magtanong forum, nakabukas yan sa Chrome. So it makes things easier in my head to have certain sites associated with certain browsers. Aside from browsers, I also install qBittorent for torrenting, and that can take up a whole separate video. Kadugtong nun, you also need K-Lite Codec. That's a whole other can of worms that we can talk about in a separate video. Suamtra PDF, another lifesaver. You just want to open a simple PDF. You don't want to have to use Adobe's Acrobat, which is a resource hog like many of Adobe's other programs. Para mabilis, para simple lang, I use Suamtra PDF and everything just works fine. To unzip compressed files, I use 7-zip. Allows access to all of the usual file formats. Notepad++, sometimes you just want to monkey around with a simple text file, but the original Notepad is really lacking. Enter Notepad++ and I usually use it for its tab feature. It's sort of like a browser where you can have multiple text files open in different tabs. You might not think you need this, but once you try it, you can't go back to having just one text file open. There are other advanced features, like you highlight a word and then it automatically highlights the other instances of that word in the text file. So there are a lot of quality of life improvements, even for basic users such as myself, and for advanced users like coders. Google Backup and Sync, I have a lot of files in Google Drive, and there's a recent update where Google Drive now mimics a local drive, so it gets assigned a drive letter, making it even easier for less advanced users to just use it like a normal drive. The sync feature has also been updated. You'll notice when you're in Microsoft Word or Excel and you save the document in real time, there's a small check when it tells you that, okay, nakasave na to sa cloud and, you know, you don't need to worry na lahat ng changes mo, okay na. Ninite offers a lot of the usual antivirus programs, but I don't use any of them. Okay na yung Windows Defender sa akin, which is the included program in Windows 10. Kapag dumadaan ako sa mas marumi or yung mas dark na portions ng World Wide Web, I do sometimes use deeper networks Pico, which provides added firewall and antivirus protection via hardware. See the review in the video above. And the Pico provides me the protection I need along with Windows Defender. That covers everything I get from Ninite, but there are some programs that still aren't on Ninite yet. Chief among these is Feem. File transfers from mobile to desktop is such a pain in the ass, but you need it all the time. Your photos, your videos, things you get on your phone, you want to transfer it to your desktop. There's no easy way to do that. The best way I found is through Feem, which connects through Wi-Fi. You're also not locked into one ecosystem. You can transfer iPad to Windows, Android to Windows, Windows to iPad. It's basically platform agnostic. Next is Brave Browser. So alongside Firefox and Chrome, I do use Brave as my third primary browser. Brave has a lot of anti-tracking built in. So it rejects the beacons, cookies, trackers, things like that. So mas mabilis mag-load yung mga websites kasi you don't need to load tracking mechanisms that come with a lot of modern sites these days. Plus, you do earn crypto from using it. The browser will display ads to you, but you can tell it the frequency. They're very unobtrusive really and I don't mind seeing them. A nice touch, parang kumikita ka habang nagsasurf ka. So any PC for me, I install those programs. I think anybody can find them super useful. But for my specific use case na gusto ko mag-gaming, of course, I also install Steam and Epic Games. I love Steam, Epic Games, I love the competition that you give Steam. And basically, between those two, you can find most any game that you want. And for editing, because a lot of my work nowadays has to do with video, I use the Vinci Resolve, which is really a great free editing program. Anything you can do in other paid programs, you can do in DaVinci for free. I've also tried several other editing programs. DaVinci was the most intuitive to use. Don't get me wrong, mahirap talaga magsimula sa editing, especially if you're like me na wala kang background. Pero kung tiis-tiis ka lang, you eventually get the hang of it, at least the very rough basics. Parang DaVinci is the easiest way to go about learning that. And once you're past the basics, it's also a very good advanced editor. I'm just now starting to learn how to color correct and other advanced graphics work and things like that. So yun yung mga programs na auto-install sa akin. If you have any other program that you personally put on your own builds every single time, please do let me know in the comments because I'd like to check them out. And thank you to our top fans! Na-afford na namin itong upuan na to! Hindi, joke lang. Thank you to Leah Magnaye, Ian Meru, Richard Onkinko, ITX Addict, John Ruben Ocha, Christian Espinosa, and Rafael James. Thank you for supporting the channel.